Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is how to register yourself as an engineer in Canada. Now we know that there are a lot of immigrants who move here and majority of them migrate to Canada after finishing the graduation. Let's say if you are an engineer, I'm talking about civil engineer, mechanical, electrical engineers, they normally find it hard to get employment once they migrate to Canada because they are not registered over here as an engineer. Now, before we talk about the process of registering yourself, let's discuss the advantages you might have if you are registered over here as an engineer. The first thing is you might get better job opportunities. So registered engineers, whether it can be an EIT, which is an engineer in training, or a p.eng, that is a professional engineer, get better job options as compared to non-registered engineers in Canada. The next thing is better pay. Registered engineers obviously get more pay as compared to the non-registered engineer. And the third benefit is you get access to a network of professional engineers which can help you in your job search, your guidance, and your further education. So these are the advantages you might have if you are registered as an engineer in this country. The next thing is, what is the process of registering yourself? So the first thing is to find the governing body of your province, because you need to register yourself in the province in which you are operating. Let's say you are living in British Columbia, you need to register yourself in BC as a professional engineer. So now let us talk about the process of registering yourself as an engineer. We'll take an example of registering yourself in British Columbia. I think the process is similar for all the other provinces with some small modifications. So the first step is to find the governing body. For BC, it is EGBC, which is Engineers and Geoscientists of British Columbia. You need to set up an account and upload all the information for your education and your experience. Once you upload this information, you need to apply for an assessment. So they'll ask for your proof of status. It can be your work permit or your PR card to show your status in this country. The next thing is your transcripts. So the transcripts are of your education, and you need to send all the transcripts from your university. You cannot send the transcript yourself. Please keep that in mind. Other option is you can submit your WES report, which is equivalent to your transcript. Okay, so that gives them enough proof about your education. The next thing is the self-evaluation tool, in which you need to take all the courses that you have completed in your country when you finished your graduation. So once you upload all this information, it will take a bit of time for EGBC to verify all the information, and then they will get back to you. So there are three possible outcomes that can happen once the evaluation is done by EGBC on your profile. The first outcome is all your education and experience is valid, and you might get registered as an EIT, which is engineer in training, or a professional engineer. Now, before we move ahead, let's discuss the difference between an EIT and a professional engineer. So an EIT is a person who has enough education and experience of less than 4 years. In order to become a PEng, you need to have at least 4 years of experience with 1 year of experience in Canada. If you don't satisfy that condition, then you cannot be considered a PEng. You will be considered as an EIT. And you can apply for a PEng once you complete your experience. So the next outcome can be, they might accept the education and experience that you have submitted, but you might to take some additional courses. So let's say I'm talking about a mechanical engineer who has migrated from a different country. He has uploaded all the documents. So EGBC can come back and say that, yes, we accept your educational credentials, but you need to take these two courses in order for qualifying as an EIT in this province. So that is the second outcome. And the third outcome is your education and experience is not satisfactory. You might need to take some additional courses in order to get registered as an engineer in this country. So based on your experience and qualification, you might have one of these three outcomes. And once you satisfy the criteria, you might get registered as an engineer in this province. As we are talking about British Columbia, then you might be registered as an engineer in BC. Once you get registered as an engineer, you need to pay the registration fee, and for your assessment, you need to pay the application fee. And till you become a PEng, you need to pay the registration fee every year. Once you are registered as an EIT in the province of British Columbia and you complete 4 years of experience overall with 1 year of experience in Canada, then you can apply for your PEng. In order to become a p.eng, you need to give some additional exams, which we'll talk about in a different video. But these are the steps you need to take if you want to register yourself as an engineer in Canada. So guys, I hope you really like this video, and if you have any questions about this topic, you can please get back to me in the comment section and I'll try to respond to you as soon as possible. And in the meantime, please like, share and subscribe for more updates on this channel. Thank you.